Welcome back everybody, Barry Mountford here. In this video, I'm going to talk through my favourite 5 lenses for shooting in a tiny home studio. Right after this. Yes folks, so following on from my shooting in small spaces series that I said I was going to produce for this channel, today we're going to be talking about my 5 recommended lenses for shooting in a small studio. Now I've been working this little studio space for the past couple of years now, so I've had to find lenses that are going to suit working in this smaller environment, ones that can get the most out of this environment too whilst shooting it, whether that's portraits or products or any kind of project that I have in mind. So with that being said, I'm going to kick it off with a lens that I believe that everybody should have in their bag. That's my opinion, but it's a great lens, inexpensive lens, and that is the Nifty 50. It's a 50mm 1.8 lens, and I honestly believe that everybody should have this lens in their bag. It's great for low light with having the aperture of 1.8. It is super, super sharp because it's a prime lens. And if you want to zoom, you just walk forward and backward, zooming with your feet. But it's a great all-round lens, great for portraits, great for headshots. In the studio, obviously, I tend to get people to sit down in the studio with it being such a small space. And obviously, this allows me to get a nice full shot of them. And with this floor space in and with the background, some of the background in too, and it's just a great lens. Also as well, if I ever had to choose between any lens being in my bag or the only lens being in my bag, I reckon it would probably be the 50mm lens, even for landscapes. You know, if you're out on landscapes and you're shooting with your camera, obviously you shoot landscape like that, you can just stitch a couple of images together, take 3 images with the 50mm lens and get that wide angle of view. You can do it always as well. It's just obviously having that little extra thought before you take the shot and what you can actually produce. So definitely highly recommend the 50mm 1.8. Now not just the Nikon, you can get the Canon, you can get lots of 50mm and they're just a brilliant all-round inexpensive lens. They're all plastic and cheap, but great for portraits and also brilliant for video too. So that's my first recommendation. The second is following on is another prime lens, and it's probably my favorite portrait lens that I do use, I think. And that would be the Nikon 85mm 1.8. Now you can get this, obviously the Canon version, Sony version, I think. But again, the low light capabilities, that 85mm focal length is just perfect for portraits, I think. And in this studio, I can pretty much, if I back myself, I'll put a link to the video where I give you the measurements to the studio, exactly what the size of the studio space is, my shooting space. With this 85mm lens, I can kind of back right up to the back wall, and I can pretty much get a full length shot in with the 85mm lens. It's a bit of a squeeze, but I can do it. So it is a great lens, like I say, super, super sharp, love it, and perfect for this small space too. Now just before we go on, all these lenses I'm going to show you, these are all for the full frame and DX, so you can use them on both crop sensor and full frame. And I've bought these for that reason. I have a crop sensor body and I have a full frame body. I shoot mainly full frame in the studio, but if I'm out and about, sometimes I like you just use the DX, the crop sensor, for that extra reach and that extra length sometimes, mainly on the longer lenses. But just having that option to shoot between DX and full frame and having the glass that's going to go on both is so much better than just buying for a DX camera or just for a full frame camera. It allows that more versatility of your equipment, so bear that in mind too. Now this third lens is a lens that pretty much, it's so much fun. It's a great portrait lens and you can just get some extraordinary shots because it's a macro lens. It's the 100mm 2.8, the Takina 100mm 2.8 lens. Now this lens I've used for portraits, I've used for close-ups, I've used for macro shots, I've used for video too. It's brilliant for video also, shooting in the small space as well, because it allows you to get right in close and just get some phenomenal shots. It really is great. I've used it on the last few projects I've shot with the miniature stuff. It gives you that complete different angle that you kind of get really with another lens. You can get right in close and it almost makes the images look believable because you're so close. Just a brilliant, brilliant lens to have in your bag. So that's the Takina 100mm 2.8. Now you can buy the Nikon version of this. Canon does one too. But this one in particular, I find it's just super, super sharp. And I just love this lens. I love the Takina. It's just quality, really is brilliant. So that's the third lens. Now I'm going to show you, say for instance, if you're on a budget, I've got a perfect lens for you. I think, my opinion, perfect lens. If you're on a budget, it's a kit lens. Probably about, I don't know, you pick them for about £30-40, which is really, really inexpensive. And that is the Nikon 28-80mm. Now, this is a great all-round lens. It's a kit lens. It came with the cameras a lot. It's an old lens, but it came with the cameras a long time ago. But it's super. This is the 3.5-5.6. It's the D version, 28-80. But it's just super quick to autofocus. Honestly, it really is quick for a lens that cheap. And it's super light as well. Know if anybody knows what the 24-70 is like, that's quite a heavy lens. It's just super, super light to carry around. And obviously it's widest 0.28mm, you're shooting at 3.5, so it's not too bad, but it really is sharp too. It's a nice sharp kit lens, so I would highly recommend that if you're on a budget, because it's great for the studio. You can get a wide shot, you can get a wide landscape shot if you're outside too, but also it shoots at 80mm, so it's a great portrait lens too. You tend to in the studio, you're not too much worried about the f-stop in the studio, really, unless you're shooting some really creative images and you want to shoot at 1.8, 2.8. But I tend to shoot around about f8 if I'm in the studio anyways. So shooting at f8 on this lens is going to be, you're not really going to notice much of a difference between that and say the 50mm prime. It's going to be very minimal, especially in the studio environment when you're using flash and continuous lights. It's going to give you a great, really great results. So that's the Nikon 28-80mm, 3.5-5.6, and that's the D version. Okay, there are a few versions you can get of this lens, but just make sure it's at the D version. But really, really great versatile lens if you're starting out. I'll not get rid of this lens, even though it's an old cheap lens. This is always going to stay with us because it's very versatile and very handy to have and very light too. So that takes us to my favorite lens probably of all time, shooting portraits, for shooting landscapes, for shooting backgrounds for my composite images, and for shooting on video. It's just an all-round lens. It's a lens that really that just does it for me, and that is the Takina 16-28mm 2.8. Now, yeah, 20. I tend to shoot portraits at 28mm with this in the studio. Now, I know a lot of people will be saying you shouldn't be shooting 28mm for portraits. That's just a big no-no. Well, it is. There is a lot of distortion in this lens, but when you're looking through the camera and the viewfinder, you can see where that distortion's happening. You can see if it's making the head look big, if the nose look big, the hands look big, the forearm. You can see all that. So there is definitely an angle that you need to find. There's a sweet spot with this lens that just produces, for me, it just produces an amazing portrait. I just love it. It's nice and close. It just does something for me. That kind of angle does it for me more than any of the other focal lengths that I have. So shooting a 28, it's just more of a dramatic, more of an imposing style. And I just love shooting at 28mm in the studio. And like I say, obviously I shoot all this for my backgrounds, landscapes as well. And it's super, super sharp. I think out of all the lenses, this is probably the sharpest lens, believe it or not. And that's saying something for a zoom lens at 16-28mm. It's phenomenally sharp. If I had one fault to pick with it, I mean, obviously it's a heavy lens too. It's a big, heavy lens. But if I had one fault to pick with it, would be the big bulbous head on it, and the fact that it was really difficult when I first bought this lens to get to purchase any kind of like ND filters or graduated ND filters for shooting the landscapes and the backgrounds, circularizing, polarizing filters. Now I did buy the Photo Deox kit, which allows you to attach a big circle to that, and then you can attach filters, but the filters are huge. I think the filters are 6-inch by 9-inch, but I do believe Lee filters now do a really good selection of filters and kits that work with that lens and similar lenses to it as well. Well, yeah, I think that is my number one portrait lens of all time. I just absolutely love it. I know people say you shouldn't, but it's my choice. That's what I like to look at. All my images that I've got on my wall are shot with that. A lot of the stuff on my website's all shot with that. All my creative portraits are all shot with the 28mm. Just a great all-round lens. So like I say, obviously I'm shooting in the studio with a full frame camera, more, I would say 99.9% of the times, to get the most out of these lenses and the most out of the space too. But all the lenses that I've chose, you can shoot on a crop sensor body as well. So if you are starting out and you're looking, trying to find out what lenses to buy for your crop sensor camera, I would highly recommend you buying lenses that you know are going to work on a full frame camera, because at some point down the line, I've no doubt that you might want to step up to a full frame camera, and it's worth spending the money correctly in the first place, so you haven't got to spend it again when you want to change. Okay, so bear that in mind. So that's it for this video, folks. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you can take something away from this, and I hope it helps you if you're shooting in a small area, small space, bedroom, kitchen, living room at home, and you want to know, you're looking at purchasing your next lens and you're looking to see what lenses are going to suit that type of environment. Well, I find that these lenses are perfect for this small studio space. So I really hope you've found it helpful and you can take something away from that. If you have, give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already subscribed, hit that subscribe button, folks. I really like you guys to tag along and watch me in more videos down the line and follow me in my journey, as I'm going to be producing more videos for this channel with this kind of thing in mind, with shooting in small spaces. And don't forget to hit that notification bell so you can see when each video is posted. So with that being said, folks, I think that pretty much covers everything for this video. And I'll see you guys in the next one.